Hello, and welcome to a quick tutorial that will show you how to connect Ableton Live and Propellerhead Reason on a Mac. Live and Reason communicate using a protocol called ReWire, which is installed at the time of the Reason install. This software, ReWire, is usually activated automatically by the programs when they need it. So this means you've probably heard that to connect these programs, all you have to do is launch Live first and launch Reason second. So if you're having trouble connecting them, you might be wondering, well, I am doing that, so what's wrong? Well, the most common problem that people encounter when trying to connect Live and Reason and having difficulties with it is that the programs are not both running in either 32-bit mode or 64-bit mode. So one program is running in 32-bit mode and the other is running in 64-bit mode. If they're not running in the same mode, then they cannot communicate with each other, even though they're running on the same computer and they're both communicating with ReWire, because one is communicating with the 32-bit version of ReWire and one is communicating with a 64-bit version of ReWire. So how do you find out what version of each of these programs you're running? I've brought up this article that I'll link in the comments, and it explains that all versions of Ableton prior to 8.4 are 32-bit. So if you're running a version prior to 8.4, you're running a 32-bit version of Ableton. Otherwise, for later versions, you can go to the About Live menu and find out if you're running 32-bit or 64-bit. Ableton generally provides both 32-bit and 64-bit binaries that you can download. So if you have one version later than 8.4 and you want the other, you can generally find that on the Ableton website and download the other version. Well, what about Reason? For Reason, version 8.2 and later is only 64-bit. For versions 6 to 8.1, there are 32-bit and 64-bit versions, both included in the same application. So what that means is, generally, for your operating system, if it's a 64-bit operating system, a more recent computer and a version of Mac OS, you would be running the 64-bit version of Reason automatically. However, if you follow the instructions on this page, which I will also link in the comments, then you can run Reason in 32-bit mode if for some reason you have to run a 32-bit version of Live. Okay, so now that we understand the difference between 32-bit and 64-bit versions of Reason and Live, we can launch Live and Reason together so that they can communicate with each other. So first we launch Live. I already have Live running. And next, we launch Reason. This seems so simple because it is simple. This is Reason version 8.3, the latest version as of the time of the recording. I log in. And now we see in the hardware interface section of Reason that Reason is running in ReWire slave mode. So it's using the ReWire protocol to communicate with Ableton, and it is the slave, which means that Ableton is controlling the tempo, the timing, when the song is running, when it's not, what measure the song is on, etc. And Reason is responding to those events and that information and adjusting its own timeline and graphical interface accordingly. So we can see this because if we start Ableton, we see the Reason transport also started and they are synchronized. You can see I'm in about measure 6 here and I can measure 6, 7 here. Great. And if I stop it, they both stop. If I reset the location of the transport to measure 1, they both go to measure 1. Awesome. But the real question is, how do I get sound between Reason and Ableton? I want to use the Reason synths and have the music appear in my Ableton set. So for that, what you'll need to make sure is that your I/O section of Ableton is showing, and that controls where your input and outputs are coming from. So by default, when I create this audio track, it's taking its audio from my external in, which is basically my USB audio interface or other audio interface that I've selected in the preferences. But really, I want my audio to come from Reason. It'll automatically connect to mix channels left and right, channels 1 and 2. And then I want to monitor input so that I can hear the sounds coming out of Reason in real time as they're produced. So to test this, I can run this drum machine I have in Reason. And there I see sound is coming from Reason into Live. Awesome. Now this works just like any other audio input in Live. I can arm it for recording and record some of it. And just get a clip right here and stop it whenever I want. Then I can stop the transport and I can play back my clip. If I change the monitor mode to auto, it will use the clip instead of the live input from Reason. And there we go. And I can use all of Ableton's time stretching tools and things like that. Awesome. So that works for basic recording. But if I had another instrument in Reason, like let's say I had a subtractor playing the default bass guitar, and I added a matrix to play some of that sound, I can hear the sound, and it's coming through the same channel in Live. So if I play the drum machine, they both get played through the same channel. Now this could be convenient in some cases if you want to isolate all your Reason instruments and have them come in on one channel, and then you can mix them using the controls in Reason or the mixer up here, which has the same effect. But what if you wanted to do something like apply a delay effect on your Reason bass line? And you wanted to use the Ableton delay effect. How could you isolate the bass guitar patch and the sound coming from it from the drums track? Well, it's not that hard, actually. So basically, we go to Reason. We select... Well, let's just start this playing. Okay. So we press tab to switch over to the back of the rack. Make sure that audio I/O is showing at the hardware interface. Open the input for the bass guitar, the mix channel, and then connect the direct out from the bass guitar to channel 3 and 4. Now you heard it drop out of the mix there. It's no longer coming through channel 1 and 2. But if I create a new audio track in Live, set the input to Reason, and this time set the input to channels 3 and 4, there's that bass track. Then I can add a delay directly to the track.